second everyone so far. Okay, that's a great job, team. That dress up, but that's okay. Tomorrow, hat day. Everybody bring in a few hats.
What about double day? When is that?
There are no double days. Hat day. We cheated last year, they dropped it. We had a better idea. If somebody wears a t-shirt and jeans, they're still crying. So they just so now we're doing the hats tomorrow. Tonight there's a basketball game here. Boys basketball with Mid Valley. That's a big point, but more importantly, is the cheering contest. We got ripped last time in the cheering contest. We came in second. We came in first, but we came in second. Tonight, let's get the people here and win this attendance. Let's win the hat day. Now, we've had some real trouble with getting our events organized for Friday. Because of those two snow days we had. So I really want to be in, see me, and maybe we can make an arrangement. What we've done with this, we've taken our last 2 years, the teams that were there for the last 2 years that came in first or second,
good job.
Two, Tommy and Colette, doing a bat race. And we will count to 10 this year. Yeah. Kodak doesn't lie, and we got him on film cheating 2 years in a row. But we'll get him this year. The Frisbee race, Keith Migalski, and then all the Nakanik girls. Jenny Miesler, Laura Wilkinlow, and where's Adam Rare? You're an ass, right? Skateboard race, Matt Evanoski.
Attention, please. On behalf of the administration, faculty, and student council, it is my distinct honor to welcome you to the 1990 Spirit Games. Introducing the competitors, the freshmen. This year's torchbearer is Student Council President Tracy Schwartz.
Thank you. matter, she's last anyway.
Thank you.
Okay, juniors, cheer Tom on. Come on.
Go! So, you threw the paint. Must be questions.
Right?
Yes.
too bad. I gotta get this for the class.
Thank you. Thank you. Second place, sophomores. Lip sync results. In fourth place, freshman. In third place, sophomores. Correction. In third place, juniors. Second place, sophomores.
second place.
Tell them to turn around.
In second place, the juniors.
Are you sure you didn't instruct anybody to go to the back?
approximately 1 minute. How do you always end with? One breath, we check for a pulse. We have a pulse. Keep breathing. Is he breathing? He's not. Okay. Reform. One every how many seconds? Okay, he's breathing again. And now you go back on the couch with your girlfriend, right?
Call an ambulance. Second breath, check for a pulse. Just check for a pulse in his arm.
No pulse.
Monitor. Okay. If you're pushing on this person's chest and all of a sudden you feel some ribs snap under your hand, you stop, right? Okay, you've been doing this for approximately 1 minute. Check for a pulse. We have a pulse, but he's not breathing. One every how many seconds? Okay, he's breathing again, he has a pulse, we saved his kid's life. Right, then you go back on his couch with your boyfriend, right?
No, I can't. Last seconds.
I either start over, or if nobody called the ambulance, then I have to go call and come back and start back with two ventilations, check the pulse.
Okay, now let's say we did it the first time.
Really? You checked him out? No, before. CPR is fine. Okay? Check inside him out. There's nothing in there. Okay, he's still conscious, so keep going. Try to knock it out of him. Anything in there?
No.
Not yet. Nothing in there, but you passed out on it. Which means he needs help. Good. Can't get anything in there. Okay. Got an obstruction. Can't do anything. Now he's passed out. What do you got to do? Oh, still got that obstruction. You gotta get rid of that sucker. Nothing. They're good. Okay, check before you breathe in there. Check it, because you don't want to blow that thing back in the...